Today we will study the topic introduction of macroeconomics. First, we need to understand what is economics. Many times, or we can say daily, you go to market, you purchase items from the market and pay some of the amount in return to the shopkeeper. You all do that? That is the economic transaction where you are receiving some items in return of some amount. You are paying amount and you are receiving the items. There, that is called the economic transactions. And the study of all these economic transactions is called economics, that you studied last year in class 11. Now we will focus on the types of economics. Generally, we consider in two types, microeconomics and macroeconomics. Now, what is micro and what is macro? Both are the Greek terms. And the meaning, micro. You have studied microorganisms in science. That means very small living beings. So here, micro means small, where you talk about individual, you talk about household, you talk about one industry or one sector of economy. Then macro means bigger. Jab aap badi baat karte, when you talk bigger, in the bigger sense, that is called macro. So when you talk about economy as a whole, jab aap puri economy ek saath consider karenge, that will be called the study of macro economics. So, when we study microeconomics, we face the problems of choice and scarcity. But when we study macroeconomics, we deal with the problems of inflation, the problem of unemployment, and the problem of development and growth of country. Now, how both of these are different? What are the differences in both of these? So, first difference, that is on the basis of study. The basis of study in microeconomics is individual, is household, or personal, one individual factory, or individual sector of economy. Whereas in macroeconomics, it is the complete economy in at once. The second difference, economic variables. What variables we study when we study microeconomics? That is choice, that is scarcity of resources and the problem of individual or consumers' demand and supply. But when we study macroeconomics, we will be studying all these in aggregate terms, aggregate demand in the economy and aggregate supply in the economy. Then economic agents. Economic agents means the person, the people, the institutions which are taking part in the economic activities. So when we talk about microeconomics, the agents are individuals, households. But when we talk about the macroeconomics, the agents are commerce institutions like SEBI, Securities Exchange Board of India, TRAI, Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, RBI. Ye jitne bhi institutions hai, these are the economic agents in macroeconomics, because they form the policies and they work for the development of the country. Degree of education. The degree of aggregation is on individual level when we talk about the microeconomics, but when we talk about the macroeconomics, it is on the bigger sense. It goes for the complete economy. Different sets of assumptions. When we study microeconomics, we take unemployment, we take inflation as constant. But when we go to study macroeconomics, the economic variables which were constant in microeconomics, now they are in the front position. Here, when we talk about the macroeconomics, we study unemployment, we study poverty. These are the basic issues, and the choice and scarcity, they remain constant. Now, if we talk about microeconomics, choice is the main point that we study. But when we come here in macroeconomics, that remain constant. And here we study about the unemployment, we study about the inflation and all other problems which our economy is facing. Then central issues. To continue, last point, the central issues in microeconomics were problem of choice, problems scarcity of resources. But we come to study macroeconomics, our central issues changes and it comes to study poverty, we come to study unemployment and all other issues. Method of study. When we study microeconomics, we study economics at individual level. When we study macroeconomics, we study economics in a broader sense. So the method is becomes very detailed. You can say we are studying partial equilibrium when we talk about microeconomics, and when we study macroeconomics, we study general equilibrium analysis. सारी चीजों को एक साथ हम study करते हैं. और when we study about microeconomics, we study equilibrium in one sector, in one industry, or in one factory, or in one particular household. Now, micro and macro both are related to each other, but when we study micro and macroeconomics all together, it doesn't mean both have the same meaning. Suppose if we talk about savings. Savings, if we study it in microeconomics, you will feel saving is good for economy. Why? Because if a person saves more, he will be having more money, and when he will be having more money, it will be beneficial for him. But when we talk in macroeconomics, if person starts saving, then what happens? The cash goes out of the economy, and when cash goes out of the economy, the producer gets lesser money to spend on for their investment, and when they have the lesser money, they will not be able to give jobs to more and more people. That will bring our economy slow down, and that will have a different type of effect on us. Many people will start losing job. When many people will start losing job, demand in the economy will decrease, and as the demand decreases, many of us will feel will not be getting work, will not be getting jobs. Supply bhi kam karni hogi, demand bhi kam hoti jayegi. Dheere dheere we'll feel ourselves in a trap where we cannot go for the growth. So saving is good in microeconomics, but the same saving has a bad impact in when we study macroeconomics. So it doesn't